for that.
Not at all.
Oh, good grief! He hit the kid right in the back of the head. That phone is... His telephone is... Here comes missing. He bursts that phone right over Jason Hervey's head.
Everybody, and welcome to Worldwide Wrestling. I'm Tony Schiavone. Like I told you last week, a very special announcement. My new co-host of Worldwide Wrestling, let me bring him in right now, the greatest U.S. heavyweight champion of all time, Magnum T.A. Magnum, it's great to be working with you again.
Well, Tony, I can't tell you what a pleasure it is to be here. You know, the whole wrestling world is full of excitement right now, and I'm staying in the hot spot, and I'm glad here to be by you.
What a week to be with me to start out. This is the Great American Bash weekend. It's this Sunday only on pay-per-view. And, of course, we had a bulletin last week on our program talking about now the WCW world title is now vacant.
Shocking news, but I can't wait to see what kind of repercussions this has in the Great American Bash.
The Great American Bash is this Sunday. And, fans, we have a very, very exclusive announcement from Mr. Jim Herd, Executive Vice President of World Championship Wrestling, not only concerning the world title and it being vacant, but concerning the two men who will go up in the main event this Sunday at the Great American Bash. Let's hear right now these comments from Mr. Jim Herd.
Hello, wrestling fans. Jim Herd, Executive Vice President of World Championship Wrestling, with a very important statement for you fans. World Championship Wrestling is saddened to report that after extensive negotiations with Nature Boy Ric Flair, stretching over the course of nearly 1 year, the parties have been unable to arrive at a mutually satisfactory contractual relationship. As a result, the WCW board has decided that the best course of action for WCW and its fans is to declare the World Championship title vacant and to determine a new champion at the Great American Bash this Sunday in Baltimore. Lex Luger, the number one contender and current United States champion, will remain on the title card at the Bash. His opponent, as determined by the WCW board, is one you've been waiting for and asking for a long time. It's Barry Windham versus Lex Luger at the Great American Bash in Baltimore. On a personal note, I'd like to take this opportunity to extend my best wishes to Ric Flair and wish him the best in the future. He is a great champion.
The following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, the chairman of the board of the Diamond Exchange, Diamond Dallas Page, along with, at 298 pounds, the Diamond Stud. His opponent from Indianapolis, Indiana, 208 pounds, Rick Ryder.
That's right, Diamond Dallas Page here. Win 6'7", 298 pounds of chiseled stone and bad to the bone, the Diamond Stud. Now, where's that girl? Where's that girl? Bring her on up here. Applied for the job earlier. That's right. We're looking across the country and around the world for a woman to go around the world with this man right here. To be his personal... Hey, baby, slow down.
Whoa.
Slow down. To be his personal valet.
She's excited.
Gets to handle the hunk. If you think you got what it takes, peel, real deal. Not bad. Don't call us, we'll call you. You were wonderful. You were marvelous, but see ya.
Well, Mag, I know you're going to be talking to the Diamond Stud and Diamond Dallas Page a little bit later on in the program, but what criteria does these girls have to meet? I mean, each one, to me, have seemed awfully good, but it hasn't worked out yet for her.
I think the Stud is playing a little bit of a head game here, trying to send a message out to all his competition that he dominates everyone around him like he does his opponents in the ring.
All right, a big slap right to Rick Ryder. The Diamond Stud, intimidation plus, but the man is really talented. There's a knife edge as he has a much smaller man, Rick Ryder, into the corner. Now, sending him to the ropes on the left side. Reversal, Ryder. Well, that's a valiant effort right there. That may have been a low blow. Look at the power, though, Meg.
Unbelievable power. We see such big athletes that keep getting bigger and stronger in World Championship Wrestling, but this Stud has really set a new water level mark that a lot of people are going to have to step up and meet that mark and see if he is the Stud that he says he is.
Side of the head now. Pick up Diamond Stud, holding Ryder up. You can hear Diamond Dallas Page in the background. And he may be going up top with him. This is a very dangerous thing to do, not only for the Diamond Stud, but of course his opponent.
It's a good way for a man to get his shoulder broken right there. You see 290 pounds plus driving his opponent down right on that shoulder blade. I wouldn't be surprised if this guy goes out here on a stretcher.
All right. Chisel Stone and bad to the bone. You heard it from Diamond Dallas Page. Of course, we all know what happened with the Z-Man when they ripped the clothes off of the Z-Man, the suit. And now the Diamond Stud calling out to the fans. I don't know what he can do here. Oh, wait! Right on the chest.
Tremendous agility and extension for a big man. I mean, this guy moves like a 220-pounder, but he's carrying all the meat and muscle of a super heavy power lifter or something. This guy is really going to do a lot of damage, and the Z-Man knows all too well what kind of damage he can wreak.
Well, you know, the Z-Man reached for Diamond Dallas Page, and of course, you'll be talking about that with the Diamond Stud a little bit later on, and the Z-Man paid for it. But, you know, he's just really having his way with Rick Ryder here. And many people would feel that he can go ahead and pin him. And why in the world wouldn't he pin him in this situation?
Well, exactly what I was talking about before. People today are sending messages out. They want people like Lex Luger. They want the people in the championship wrestling to know that there's no title safe when you have a man like the Diamond Stud on the loose. Because this man can dominate this opponent with virtual ease. But he is definitely sending out a signal that he is going to wreak havoc on everybody he gets his hands on.
So in his attempt now to send out a signal, the Diamond Stud, he and Z-Man will collide this Sunday at the Great American Bash on pay-per-view. How will the Z-Man contend with the DDD, the Diamond Death Drop, and he's going to execute it right here. Oh, that's great execution.
Tremendous move. There's nobody in the sport today that can kick out of that as far as I'm concerned.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match, the Diamond Stud.
The Diamond Stud disposes, and that's putting it mildly, of Rick Ryder. Let's take a look once again, Magnum.
You see, it's 290 pounds flying through the air. I mean, he came right down on that left shoulder. I know that arm is going to be incapacitated, and here you see the coup de grace. I mean, this maneuver here is total domination and totally incapacitates anybody that feels its force. 290 pounds driving all its weight down the back of his neck and shoulders. He's out for the count.
All right, the Diamond Stud with a decisive win. And we now take you to Paulie Dangerously and the Great American Bash Control Center.
This is Paulie Dangerously inside the Great American Bash Control Center. And we got a lot to cover this weekend because this Sunday is the day. Sunday, July 14th, exclusively on pay-per-view, the Great American Bash. You already heard from Senior Vice President Jim Herd. It will be the United States Heavyweight Champion and number one contender, the total package Lex Luger, locked inside a steel cage with Barry Windham. Both men enter the cage as contenders. One man will emerge as the undisputed WCW Heavyweight Champion of the World. Also inside a cage, Missy Hyatt and Rick Steiner, two on two against me, myself, Paulie Dangerously, and the Enforcer AA, Arn Anderson. Sting in a Russian chain match against the Russian Nightmare, Nikita Koloff. Elegante in a battle of the giants against the one-man gang. 20 feet up in the air, the Skywalkers part two in a scaffold match. Beautiful Bobby and the Rapmaster PN News against stunning Steve Austin and Terrence Taylor in a lumberjack match. Big Josh against Black Blood. Bounty for the Mask. The Yellow Dog takes on Johnny B. Bad. Then you will see a six-man elimination tag team match. The Natural Dustin Rhodes and the Young Pistols will take on the Fabulous Freebirds and Bad Street. Also, the Z-Man goes against the Diamond Stud. Ron Simmons goes against Oz. And then, who truly was the dominant member of the Rock and Roll Express? Was it Robert Gibson or was it Richard Morton, the newest member of the York Foundation? Both former teammates are standing by right now with their comments about this Sunday's Great American Bash.
You know, this Sunday night, the Great American Bash, Robert Gibson, I'm going to prove to you and the rest of the world that I was the better half of the Rock and Roll Express. People used to ask me, Ricky, how come your back hurt? That's because I carried you around for 10 years, Robert Gibson. It's going to end this Sunday night.
Ricky Morton, this Sunday night at the Great American Bash, man, a match is going to take place between me and you, something I thought would never, never happen, guys. Let me tell you something. After the class, you pile drive me, you sucker punch me, boy. This Sunday night is going to be me and you one-on-one, guy, and you better be ready.
We find out this weekend who truly was the dominant member of the Rock and Roll Express, Gibson or Morton. This card was billed as the legend versus the legacy. But whose legacy? Is it Lex Luger's legacy to become the heavyweight champion of the world? Or is it Barry Windham's? Barry Windham and Lex Luger will enter a steel cage, and one man will come out as the heavyweight champion of the world. Barry Windham, right now, is standing by with his comments about his big match against the total package Lex Luger.
The World Heavyweight Championship is something that every professional wrestler at WCW wants for his very own. I've got a chance that I haven't had in 4 years. Luger, you've had your chance on many occasions. And the World Heavyweight Championship is something that I want and that I believe should be mine. And I know that you feel the very same way. Something that has never happened in professional wrestling before, a world title was held up. And two men, the very best that WCW has to offer, are going heads up for the World Heavyweight Championship. So this Sunday on pay-per-view, Mr. Luger, when you step into the ring with me, be prepared for the battle of your life. Because I am not going to turn my back on you for 1 second. Because I believe that I am the next heavyweight champion of the world, and I'm going to prove it to you.
I was wrong. It's going to be a big match. It's going to be a historic confrontation. Who's going to be the next WCW heavyweight champion of the world? The Total Package, Lex Luger, or Barry Windham? There's only one way to find out. It's by picking up your telephone. It's by calling your local cable operator and informing them. This Sunday, July 14th, I want to see the Great American Bash exclusively on pay-per-view.
Following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Detroit, Michigan, he weighs 403 pounds, the Repmaster, P.N. News.
It's like a freight train going through your brain. For PM News, the posse goes insane. The posse's pumping, there ain't no doubt. PM News is the winner. Wipe out. Yo, baby, yo, baby, yo. I said, yo, baby, yo, baby, yo.
Ladies and gentlemen, his opponent from Seattle, Washington, 244 pounds, John Peterson.
All right, the Rapmaster PN News, John Peterson. And before the match gets underway, Mag, let's hear some comments from the one and only Johnny B. Badd along with Teddy Long.
This Sunday night at the Great American Bash, Brian Pillman, that mask is going to come off and everybody's going to know you're the Yellow Dog. Then PN News, Johnny B. Badd's got a score to settle with you. Tell him, Johnny.
Oh, hush, Teddy. If you're going to show up that night, you better be ready to fight. You big old ugly bear.
Oh, hush, Johnny.
You know, Johnny B. Badd's a talented guy, and of course, he's thinking about collecting that bounty off the Yellow Dog this Sunday. But being able to handle 403 pounds in the ring coming at you is a tall order.
You know, Tony, I've seen this man. I've watched his colorful antics, you might say, that Johnny B. Badd's got. But I've looked at one thing. He's got that tremendous left hand. Well, he's untested until this time. Until he takes on a man like this big man, 400 pounds in the ring right now, and knocks him out, then he'll show me something. But right now, I've watched him with a lot of guys that we knew he could handle, and he's looked real good. But this big man here, he is the most colorful guy I've seen in a long time in professional wrestling.
All right. Left hands, combination right hands, showing Johnny B. Badd a little bit of his own medicine that time as the Rapmaster takes care of Peterson. Send him in, look at that. Agility for that weight.
I mean, to see a 400-pounder come off the ground like that and connect right on the money, that takes a lot of accuracy. This guy didn't just, he popped up out of nowhere, kind of. He surprised us here in World Championship Wrestling, and he's surprising everybody that gets in the ring with him.
Executing now, vertical suplex over the top. Just too much of PN News for John Peterson. And the big question is, how can Johnny B. Badd handle this 403-pound guy? And also, I'm wondering if Johnny B. Badd can collect that bounty and unmask the Yellow Dog.
Unmasking the Yellow Dog may prove to be the greatest challenge in wrestling. I think, not to cut you off, but there, PN News, that's something that kind of has a few memories for me there. That belly-to-belly suplex is something I've seen put a lot of people out.
Yeah, so have I. The big guy with the belly-to-belly on Peterson now. Picks Peterson up. Places him in the corner. And the Rapmaster going up top. Calling for his midleg. Nowhere to go from that.
Here is your winner, the Rapmaster, PN News.
He put him in position with the Rap Splash, and it was all over.
The Posse knows things are going my way. They know I'll make it to the top. Day by day, because I'm living life and I'm staying in charge. Yo, baby, yo, baby, yo. I say, yo, baby, yo, baby, yo.
Welcome back to Worldwide Wrestling. Magnum TA here with two real characters in the world of professional wrestling, the Diamond Stud and Diamond Dallas Page. Now, before I talk to these two gentlemen, I'd like to refresh your memory a little bit about an incident that recently occurred on nationwide television. As a matter of fact, a colleague of mine, Jim Ross, was conducting a scheduled interview with the Z-Man. And then there was a rather unscheduled appearance by the Diamond Stud and Diamond Dallas Page. What ensued therein after that point was something that would, you might say, kind of embarrassing for the Z-Man. Kind of exposed him to the wrestling world in a little different light than I think he'd like to project himself. But what happened then and what happens now after the fact can be a whole different thing, because the Great American Bash will see these two athletes collide, and now somebody has going to have to pay the piper.
Well, the bottom line is, Magnum, first of all, you take a guy like the Z-Man, a great athlete. I came down there with a stud just to give him a little of my professional advice. People pay big money for that advice, and he didn't want it. He put his hands on me. He never should have put his hands on Diamond Dallas Page, because this man right here, 6'7", 298 pounds of twisted steel and sex appeal, the Diamond Stud will answer any problems that people... their hands on me. So Z-Man, check it out. When you're back in the locker room, shaving down, blow drying your hair and oiling up, remember that the Diamond Stud's in the gym slamming and jamming, getting ready for you at the Great American Bash. And when he gets a hold of you, you know what he's gonna do? Tell him, Stud.
Z-Man, when you cross the Stud, you're gonna be seeing 3D. Diamond Death Drop.
Good God.
One thing's for sure, this confrontation is a long way from being over with, but we will see it come to a conclusion in the Great American Bash.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, accompanied to the ring by Lady Blossom from Hollywood, California. He weighs 253 pounds. The WCW World Television Champion, Stunning Steve Austin. His opponent from Yorktown, Indiana, 211 pounds, Dino McKenzie.
Hey, take a look at Kino McKenzie, and he's going up against the World Television Champion. Stunning Steve Austin with Lady Blossom. He's a man who's really got off to the right foot, but before we talk about that, interesting comments made by Diamond Dallas Page and the Diamond Stud about the situation with the Z-Man, and of course, you had the interview moments ago.
Well, it's real easy to stand there and be cocky and arrogant when you're doing an interview such as I just had with Dallas Page and the Stud, but the fact remains that they're going to have to deal with what they did with the Z-Man, and when they get in the Great American Bashes, when they get head up and there's not going to be any sucker punches, I think the Z-Man is going to deal a pretty good hand himself.
Stunning Steve Austin. Now, he is involved in a very, very dangerous matchup, as he and Terrence Taylor will be on the scaffold at the Great American Bash this Sunday, and across the ring, the Rapmaster PNUs and his partner, Beautiful Bobby. That's a very interesting matchup because of all four men, Magnum. The real veteran of the scaffold matches is Beautiful Bobby.
Well, that's correct, because going back 4, 5, even 6 years, Bobby Eaton has been up there on many occasions, and he has survived. And surviving a scaffold match is just as important as who wins or loses, because one bad fall off of that could end a career very quickly.
Stunning Steve Austin, who has been a tremendous athlete in his short period of time here at World Championship Wrestling, as McKenzie gets a boot into the chest Look at that! Power caught him right in midair.
No.
Tony, I've really been taking a close look at this Steve Austin. He came in, shocked the world, became the world's television champion in very short order. And World Championship Wrestling has been totally dominating everybody he's gotten the ring with. But you got to always look out there because you don't ever know what that Lady Blossom is going to be up to. She is very active in this man's career.
We're going to probably see her at her best, or as many people would think, her worst. What's she doing here? Wow! McKenzie. Well, she served to get his attention that time, and that was all that Austin needed. And I wonder, Mag, you know, it really is disgusting, at least to me, that a guy with his talent would even let a lady get involved in his matches.
Well, there's obviously more to this relationship than meets the eye, because this man does have all the credentials, and I foresee that he should be able to take care of business in the square circle on his own. But with this lady at his side, he becomes a double jeopardy situation for anybody that signs a contract with him. A lot of people like to have that world television title around their waist, but it's going to be a tough job getting away from Steve Austin.
Pick up. Right hand to McKenzie and to the midsection. And again. All right, Stunning Steve sending the man in, whirls and comes away with a tremendous clothesline. The lariat maneuver. What has been the key for Stunning Steve Austin has been his execution. Well, he didn't need to do that at all.
Well, that shows a little bit of this attitude thing that I'm talking about that we're seeing on a lot of athletes here in World Championship Wrestling. They're wanting people to know that there's punishment being dealt out in the ring. If you sign and get in one of these matches, you're going to be brutalized. You're going to be taken to the outer limits, because these guys are going to take care of what pays the bills.
I don't know. I don't know if I agree with that or not. Nevertheless, it's proving to be successful here, and there's a high vertical suplex that time. And so, Stunning Steve Austin, the world television champion, taking the measure of McKenzie, picks him up. It could be, and it is, the stun gun. That's his maneuver, and that put McKenzie right down. McKenzie trying to get back to his feet, but he's not going to be able to. Face first. Austin on him, hooks the far leg, and rolls over and arrogantly pins it.
Here's your winner, the WCW World Television Champion, Stunning Steve Austin.
Beautiful Bobby wants to get that World TV title back. We'll see how it happened last week or next week on our program, and here it is again.
You see the masterful execution. Everything this man does takes tremendous wind out of the sails of anybody he grabs hold of. This is a beautiful move. I've never seen anybody do it quite this way. He calls it the stun gun. This could be the coup de grace in itself, but as if to add insult to injury, he likes to get one more shot in, and that hand behind the head and driving his opponent into the mat is always what gets it done.
Your winner, the World Television Champion, Stunning Steve Austin. When we come back, we'll take a look at the situation involving El Gigante and the One Man Gang after this timeout. A couple of weeks ago, we saw Nationwide TV, the one-man gang, attack El Gigante with the help of Kevin Sullivan and cut his hair. Do you really think this has really spurred this big guy on?
I don't know if psychologically this is going to push him over the edge, but I do know with a giant, you don't want to play too many games.
Well, they played a game of cutting the hair of 7'7" El Gigante. We're going to take you back now to Nationwide TV in the month of June when this went down, and I tell you what, we all talked about it for a time to come.
El Gigante, the man with a tremendous claw. Unbelievable tendon strength, and there it is. He's got J.D. Wolf down, and he's got it pinned, El Gigante. Wait a minute, there's Sullivan.
Here we go.
Kevin Sullivan from behind on El Gigante, trying to hold him down. Here's the one-man gang. He's 420, and there's a 747. Oh, my gosh. Caving in the ribs of El Gigante.
And they're going to do it to him again.
A gang well over 400 pounds. Another one. Right in the back. They're trying to break the giant's back. And now they're on top of him. Sullivan is cutting his hair. Sullivan is shaving the giant's hair. Oh, how terrible.
400 and plus pounds sitting on his back. He couldn't move, and of course he's walking around with a definite new look. However, I think, you know, we've said it so many times, they've awoken a sleeping giant. I really think he's at the point to where he doesn't care what happens with the one-man gang.
I think we're going to see a new focus, a new intensity in the giant. I don't think anybody's even come close to intimidating him to this point. But today, he's going to send a message back, I'm sure, quite soon to one-man gang.
And we're going to hear comments from the 7'7" Argentinian giant, the big one, El Gigante, when we come back.
One-man gang, you cut my hair, and you're going to pay for it.
The following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, accompanied by the executive director of the York Foundation, Alexandra York, along with the computerized man of the 1990s, Terrence Taylor, and the newest member of the York Foundation, Richard Martin. Ladies and gentlemen, at 375 pounds, he is head of security for the foundation, Mr. Hughes. His opponent from Rock City, USA, 233 pounds, Scott Allen.
Now the York Foundation all out in their business suits right now. Richard Morton, who is having some words with the fans, Terrence Taylor, but maybe the biggest and baddest in World Championship Wrestling is the man who came into the WCW, not even as a wrestler, as a security man, Mr. Hughes.
It was my opinion, Tony Schiavone, that this man is going to make a real name for himself very quickly. Every time he walks in that ring, he never lacks his intensity. He never takes anybody lightly. No matter what kind of mismatch it looks like, he goes right for the jugular.
Mr. Hughes with the gloves on his hands, wanting to shake the hands of Scott Allen, and he just decked him. A lot of force behind those blows.
I mean, not a real wrestling maneuver, but this is a street fighting kind of guy. I mean, he's come up the hard way. You can tell he'll do anything for a dollar, and he's going to make some big dollars if he keeps wrestling like this.
Basically, decapitated Allen that time with a tremendous clothesline. Of all the great matches we have, the Great American Bash exclusively on pay-per-view this Sunday, one of the ones I'm looking forward to more than any is Richard Morton against his former partner, Robert Gibson. Morton, of course, a member of the York Foundation. Financially, I know he's doing okay, but certainly that's a big change from what we were accustomed to as we take a look at Mr. Hughes.
Now, Richard Morton, you know, 5 years ago, I would have been really blown away by what happened, you know, but I look at things today and I look at big contracts and guys looking at money, and sometimes that money's hard to turn away from. He said he'd signed his last autograph when he signed that contract. This guy here can sign your last autograph for you real quick. That scoop power slam can end it all.
Tremendous power slam. And what has been great to watch about Mr. Hughes is that in a short period of time, much like Steve Austin, he can really execute. You know, you talked about his street brawling sense, but there's a lot of wrestling ability there also.
Well, he's been standing there in the corner watching Terrence Taylor, I should call him, executing a lot of great wrestling moves for many, many months, and surely having any kind of athletic background, he's picked up quite a bit. He's been kind of getting a little tutelage as it goes along. And combining that with the skills that come out of that computerized wrestling that they're preaching and talking about, this guy could be really dangerous.
Right now, making a lot of fun of the unfortunate man, Scott Allen. And Mr. Hughes going after Allen once again. What a force he is becoming in World Championship Wrestling. Missing a clothesline. Catching Scott Allen in midair. Look at that. Look at that facial expression of Mr. Hughes. Lifts him up and drops him down with ease, I should add.
The young man might as well have ran into a boulder. That was an immovable object that he hit there in Mr. Hughes. And this man is dishing it out. I mean, serious business. If there's anybody watching that thinks this guy can't get the job done, they're in trouble.
I think anybody who would step in the ring with Mr. Hughes would be in trouble. He'll be at the Great American Bash, not only the big pay-per-view this Sunday, but of course our Great American Bash on tours going on all across the nation. And it began back, of course, on the 3rd of July. I'd like to say hello to our great fans in the Los Angeles area that watch us on KCAL. And of course, we'll be coming to the Great Western Forum with the Great American Bash on tour in the month of July. We'll be talking more about that, what an event that's going to be, on Tuesday, July 23rd. A pickup and the spike of Scott Allen. That is all
The winner of the match is Mr. Hughes.
Wait a minute, Robert Gibson is out, confronting Richard Morton. He's really walking to a lion's den here. Listen to the fans. And here we go. Now, Mr. Hughes reaching in, grabbing Robert Gibson. Dustin Rhodes is in. Double drop kick. And we really got a fight on our hands right now, Meg.
Unbelievable situation. I don't even know what Robert Gibson's thinking about. He walked right in the middle of a shark infested waters there, and Dustin Rhodes is giving it all to him. He's fighting with everything he's got.
Gibson out looking for a chair. He's got a chair. And now he's going to clear the ring. Gibson, Dustin Rhodes, taking on the entire York Foundation. And I mean it's hot as we go to the Great American Bash. Robert Gibson just walked right out regardless of the odds and tore right into the York Foundation. What an explosive situation we have had, but right now we're going to take a break. We'll be back with more on Worldwide after this.
It is set for one fall. Introducing first, from the Heartliners Collection Agency, Dirty Dick Slater, Dick Murdoch, the Hardliners. Their opponents, total combined weight, 485 pounds. First from Tampa, Florida, Sonny Trout. And from Honolulu, Hawaii, Chris Sullivan.
The Hardliners against Trout and Sullivan in this event on Worldwide. Kind of a hot situation we had to dump out of there. I tell you what, a lot of things going on between Gibson now and Morton.
Well, we know that's going to be a confrontation we're going to see in the Great American Bashes, and I for one am going to be right there because I don't know what's going to come out of that.
Tremendous. And fans, of course, as you know, you've been following the situation involving the Hardliners and the Steiners. Never before in the history of World Championship Wrestling have two men come in and taken care of the Steiners as Slater and Murdoch have done. They literally have injured both Steiners.
You know, the Steiners have faced a lot of great wrestlers. You know, they defended those World Tag Team titles against the best. But these guys come from the old school. They've got some ways that people have forgotten about. We've got this new breed of athletes today that know how to do suplexes, and they know how to do all these impressive-looking aerial maneuvers. But these guys know how to hurt you. When they grab an arm, when they get the joint going the wrong way, they capitalize on it. They have certainly capitalized on it where the Steiners are concerned.
Well, they've capitalized, and of course, they specialize in working on one part of the body, but it's the sneak attack, Magnum. It's the attack from behind. And of course, you know, they are talented. Why would they need to do something like this? Why don't they just face them head up, see who the better team is?
Well, you always have two kinds of people in this world, people that want to take the shortcut that'll do anything to get the job done, and then those guys that want to play by the rules all the time. Well, I don't find anything particularly admirable about a sneak attack, but I do have to admire the fact that these guys are ring technicians. They've got a tremendous amount of skill, and when they get hold of something, they're like a dog on a bone. It's like a pit bull getting his hold. These guys, when Murdoch and Slater come in the ring, you know somebody's literally risking losing an arm.
That's exactly what's happening, and right now, you take a look at Sonny Trout, and that wrist lock applied now. Murdoch with tremendous concentration. Look at him pulling.
I mean, Tony, take a look at this. This isn't a real spectacular thing. This is an exciting half line, but these guys, when they get hold of you, you're not getting away. They put you in a very precarious situation. You either give up, or you literally risk having something broke.
This case for Trout, it's the left arm, as it was for both Scott and Rick Steiner. And now Slater with a roundhouse right. Trout nowhere to go, pinned up against the ropes. Slater swinging neckbreaker, great execution.
You know, for a long time, Tony, I thought that the Steiners were unbeatable. I didn't think anybody would ever find a weakness. But if anybody in World Championship Wrestling has a chance at capitalizing on a weakness at this point in time, I'd say the hardliners are going to be very hard to be answered by anybody because they know how to get right to the root of a problem.
Murdoch gets the tag, and this tremendous veteran out of Texas comes in. Now they're going to let Sullivan come in. I'm not so sure Sullivan wants to come in. You always get the advantage when the man is coming through the ropes and if you're ready to hit him.
And that's a rookie's mistake. These guys obviously don't have a lot of ring time, a lot of experience. Between Slater and Murdoch, there's no telling how much ring time they've racked up over the years. And there's no wasted effort. Look at that right hand of Murdoch. I mean, he takes the guy out. He punishes him, kick in the short ribs. I mean, everything he does punishes and hurts his opponent.
The tag, and Slater is back in. Dick Slater, Dick Murdoch, the Hardliners, the Great American Bash. Of course, the Hardliners will be part of the Great American Bash on tour. We invite you also to join us for a Great American Bash pay-per-view. It is this Sunday, emanating from the Baltimore Arena, and we'll start at 7 o'clock Eastern time. And right now, it's almost been the theme of the week here on Worldwide, sending a message to someone. Of course, they have sent their message to the Steiners, and that is they are not only wanting to be World Tag Team Champions, they want to put the Steiners out.
Messages have been sent, accusations have been made, but the confrontations that are going to take place in the Great American Bashes are going to be the things that end these messages, because you can talk about it all you want, but when these guys get down to it, when they say the Steiners have to defend the World Tag Team titles in the Great American Bashes, hurt, not hurt, whatever, then we're going to find out what a man's made of.
We'll find out. The Steiners in jeopardy for the first time since their title reign began. And in major jeopardy, double elbow now, as Murdoch and Slater, they are just completely dominating this team and literally beating Chris Sullivan up.
Well, as I said, Tony, it's not real pretty, but you have to admire the way these guys use ring psychology. They cut the ring off, they utilize the tag, they always have a fresh man in, and they are relentless in their attack. And we've seen this more than once. Murdoch loves to utilize that outside ring post and take a guy's shoulder up.
And that's exactly what he's done. Sullivan is down on one knee on the bottom side. Trout's going to come over to help him. He's not going to get to because Murdoch is going to bring Sullivan back in and make the tag. That left shoulder right now has to be in a world of pain. Double team right on the shoulder of Sullivan. And now pulling up on the arm, Slater straddles, has good leverage, and that is it.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of the match, Dirty Dick Slater, Dick Murdoch, the Hardliners.
Hardliners just too much for Sullivan and Trout.
I told you, get that out of my face. Get it out of my face, I told you. Get it out of here.
And he's attacking everybody and everything. Let's take a look one more time at this wild man.
I mean, you can see the intensity in his face, a hard elbow driven across the throat. That takes all the fight out of anybody. And if you look right there, Slater's hand connected right in that shoulder that had just been injured. And it was only a matter of time before he had to submit.
We'll be back right after this. Time out.
Hi, kids. I'm Todd Champion. This is Chip the Firebreaker. We're the WCW Patriots. And Chip's got a special fire safety tip for you guys, so listen up.
Hi, kids. My fire safety tip for this week is don't play with matches. I know you've heard it 100 times, but your mom and dads were right. Don't play with matches or you'll get burned.
All right, let's talk about the Hardliners and the Steiners for a moment. It happened on Nationwide TV. They got one of the Steiners.